immune. Can we just destroy this thing? I don't know if it ever ends. I know the spell will run out. He's using just a standard sword. How long does it last again? Five rounds per level. So in her case, ...45 rounds, that is? Oh.
Swords, not words! Minsk and who? Where Minsk goes, evil stands ace. Ever jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
I await. It is done.
What? Fine.
Yep. Good to go.
Okay. So for now, at least, it's stopped summoning them.
Armored, live by the sword. Live a good life. Stand back for justice.
Yes.
What do you want?
Now you see me?
Red as rain.
This room is dominated by mineral deposits and crystals. It seems to be a natural cavern that this strange prison has been built around. The air holds an aura of power, and several pools with swirling lights grace the edge of the rough cavern. Attacker? Ah, I see whom I must talk to. No offense, Imowen, but I am curious how Sapphire will react to me. Sapphire, I have questions. Be not afraid. With a laugh like that, I'm a little worried. You have my welcome to this little piece. To my little piece of this place. I do so try to keep it more appealing than the rest. My things? How is it that you know my name? What is going on here? Your name is well known amongst those who watch. Your life's thread is bright indeed, though in your path lies many a dark and frayed end. As to easing your mind and answering such questions as those that surely plague you, it is not my place to do so. I am sorry. Then of what use can you be to me? Such assistance as you will get from me depends on yourself. Are you prepared to answer a question? To what end? Why do you need to ask me a question? I suffer a terrible curiosity. I see paths that branch in 1,000 directions, and each 1,000 again. But for all I see, Sapphire remains a mystery. All I wish is a single answer. Tip the scales this once to me, and I shall tip them to you in return. Shall you answer me, or shall you strike out on your own? I will answer your question if it will lead to your making sense. Then here is my hypothetical question. You and your sibling are captured and locked in separate cells, unable to communicate. The mage, responsible, appears and speaks. He explains his sadistic game. In each cell there is a magical button. If you press your button, and your sibling does not, you will die, but your sibling is free. Is this a riddle? Is he actually describing what's happened, or what will happen? In each cell there is a magical button. Well, I don't remember seeing any magical buttons in those cells, just that they were magically locked. But if you press your button, your sibling does not. You will die, but your sibling is free. If your sibling presses the button and you do not, they will die, but you will go free. If neither you nor your sibling presses the buttons, both of you will die. If both of you press your respective buttons, both of you will die. The mage says that you have one turn of the hourglass to decide your action, then he leaves. Min says, this is silly. Buttons are not how one escapes dungeons. I would smash the button and rain beatings liberally down on the wizard for playing such a trick. Verily, of that I have no doubt, Minsk. But the question is hypothetical and requires an answer born of the wisdom of Sapphire, not your impatience. Tell me, Sapphire, do you press the button? So pressing the button... Pressing the button... Well, it depends. Is the other person pressing the button? If we both press the button, we both die. If just I press the button, I mean, the other person, for example, Imowen, gets to go free, right? I don't know. That answer will not suffice, Sapphire. Choose again. Can you tell me again? If I press the button, and my comrade does not, the comrade goes free. I will press the button. Interesting. No action can be performed without consequences, especially that which follows the noble path. Deal with this, noble one. What? We got experience, and here's a ogre mage. Okay.
You point, I punch.
Name it. Right you are.
Yes?
Yeah.
Fall, creature, and feed the earth!
Ready and willing. All right, all right. Something up? No problem at all.
He's still hidden.
Time to move.
Oh, hello?
What is it? Such menial tasks.
Well done. It appears you can deal with the consequences of your actions. In return for your indulgence, I offer advice. Seek out Rilev. He waits for such as you. Offer him the release that he craves, and you shall find that the focus of your journey shall soon become apparent. Farewell. okay.
I am ready.
Glad you're ready. Well, that was easy for an ogre mage. The pool churns and swirls. Strange light stands within. As you stare at the pool, you catch a glimpse of a cityscape. For a brief moment, with absolute clarity, you watch as the city changes. Ages pass, and the inhabitants drop their primitive tools and ways. Discoveries are made, and the minds of the people change and grow, every day grasping a new fact or invention. The image slips away until you see only a pool. Mm-hmm. Anything else to look at?
Swords! No! Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
That's pretty random. Why would you be worried about that? Yeah, I like
a
that.
A den of stinking evil. Cover your nose, Boo. We will leave no crevice untouched.
Yep. Now you see me, now you don't.
She agrees. Okay.
This way, then?
Oops. There's a goblin here. Sneak attack?
What do you want? Gotcha. Name. Good to go.
Minsk, as a battle bow. Run, Boo, run! Feel the backhand of justice!
What about the looting? How do we... I don't have that. Trying to find that option. Gotta be in the gameplay. I don't know where the easy loot is. That's it for gameplay. Before. I'm glad there's a way to disable that, because that used to bother me. I would just select somebody to do an action, and it would go into a level up screen. Small sideboard buttons. They gotta be in here. Single click travel. Journal collapsed. Alternate renderer. It's not here. Can't be here. Oh, and here's my character sound. Well, not in here, but you go to my character. Maybe it's in here. We can do it.
You will fall by my hand.
That's the default. It's female streetwise.
Your life shall be mine.
Appearance, sounds, yeah, that's it. Colors, that's the script. Biography, Alright. These are the same options. Hold on a second, guys. Gah, I found it. It's not even a setting, it's here. There we go. An Agni Mani necklace. I'll have them take this stuff for now. Well, I'm glad we figured that out.
Ready and willing. Right you are.
Alright, so let's see if there's anything else down here. Failing.
Now you see me, now you don't.
There's a door. Oh, I wonder if it connects over here eventually. That's fine, because I want to find traps. Oh, doesn't work there either, okay. So we need to find magical ways to open these places. Oh. The pool churns and swirls. Strange lights dance within. For a brief tantalizing moment, the pool clears. You watch in wonder as a world is born. In fire and molten rock, lands rise and fall. Gaseous liquids snake and pour, and time passes. Eventually, seas are formed and a spark of life appears. The first organism is created, and plant life begins its slow, inevitable blanketing of this new world. Oh, that's interesting.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Are we seeing back into, like, the dawn of creation or something? I wonder if there can be any traps. Failed. Stop failing. Too much. Ah!
Every hamster has
it.
There's a few.
What?
Where are these? Goblin, goblin. Goblins, yes, all goblins. cool. You're doomed. Chunks. Hey, we got scrolls. If I identify.
Yes?
I'll take those. A blue stone necklace. Oh. Got a short bow. Two of them. And arrows.
Something up?
Yeah. Got some arrows. You're back in the bow business. Yeah, it just says a necklace. Cool. Sweet. Back in the bow business. What are you casting? She cast armor. I'm gonna turn the party AI off.
All right.
I'm a bit of a party pooper with that. But, I mean, did that even help her? Probably did. She has armor class 2.
Time to move?
Now you don't.
Right as rain.
Doors. One open. The hell? All right.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Let's try this door then. Corner though. Failed.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Okay. We've got a mist method. This tube is unpowered and the creature within is dead. Within the murky depths of this machine, you can see the lifeless remains of a strange creature consisting of a central orb and numerous eye stalks. It has been dead for some time. Oh, probably a beholder or something similar. We can interact with that one. That one's dead. We can interact with that one. Dead. The fluid within this device churns and bubbles, though the tank itself is empty. There's a crate here.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Yep. Which no problem.
Two magic damage.
You point bad, kicking for goodness.
Oh. Everyone's blinded. She's not blinded anymore.
sword where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
I don't think there's anything else in here.
I know this room. I've been in here. We both have. There are things in these tanks. They used to be people.
What kind of monster is this guy? Captured us easy as pie, kills whoever he wants. That could have been us in those glass things. We'll get him back, Imuin. We'll make him pay for all of this. We don't even know where we are, and my head is still doing funny things. He said something. Something about potential. He said something like, releasing power within you so it could be used. But if it means taking part in horrible things, I don't like this place. Can we go? Yeah, we have to find out how to get out of here first. Anything else in here, first of all? This looks like a big room. Okay.
Something up? This way, then?
Not leaving shadows.
Nature this? Could find a home here if it were properly cleansed and balanced.
Failing, yeah. Oh, there's a... an ice method.
Minsk and who stands?
Okay, now we can see the whole room. Nice going. Not Jahira, that is. Oh. I was gonna say Imuin, but it's actually me that had the crushing blow. And 420 experience. Smoke him if you got him. So the creature within is dead.
Time to move? Gotcha.
A den of stinking evil. Cover your nose, Boo. We will leave no crevice untouched.
Some bullets. What about this? Oh, trapped. We have a lot of experience. They locked the box. Oh, some kind of magical quarterstaff here. And we've also got this. This one trapped too. One gold. A few more arrows. I'll leave the bow. Okay, so someday I'll have a sling again. Quarterstaff plus one. I'll throw this one out. Magical properties. Alright. Actually, do that. We need mage robes. Alright, so what if we start interacting with these things, Minsk?
Every jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
The creature within this tube seems to be alive, albeit barely. The cells that power the tube are lifeless. You'll need to find newer power cells to revive the creature. We can revive the creature. So on the lookout for some power cells. Same here. I'm assuming they're all the same, but I'll check them anyway. We need power cells. Just making sure there's nothing laying on the ground that's not highlightable, like an interactable thing. Funny, these things, like, they have claws that reach out. Like, if you go to interact with this thing, I mean, not that you can, but then the claws grab you. That might be where we need to put a power cell. Or maybe it's on the actual tube itself.
A den of stinking evil!
Stinking evil!
Cover your nose, boo! Armored, sharpened, and raring to go!
Well. Alright, so we've got a door here. We've got a door here and a more corridor to go down to. Down through. Quite a big area. Magically held doors here, here, and here. So, the only way I could see it is to go check this door and go forward through the tunnel. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.